Welcome to our TeamGuru video tutorial. Today I would like to share with you our new functionality when you will be able to create and manage your action list template, enhanced checklist template, and also corrective actions template. An action list template type you will be able to use in all of our modules where you can work with actions such as action list, meeting, leadership standardize work, and so on. Checklist template, here I would like to point out it is enhanced version, so you will have more options to work with than before, and you can use it in our checklist module. And corrective actions template type you can use in all of our modules where you are working with corrective actions, such as root cause and analysis, AD reports, quality alerts, and so on. And let's start first with action list template type. In Action List submenu or other modules using Actions, you will find a new addition, Action List Template. And this will give you option to create one or more templates for your projects. And in your Action List Template, you can predefine your main actions. You can add as many as you need to. You can also add sub-actions and you will complete all the details the same way as you are doing in our Action List. You can add labels, flags, you can also automatically predefine your offset days. You can add responsible approver if needed, and you can also add any attachments and related documents. And as always, you will be able to protect your settings of this template and choose your document administrators, and they will be the only ones who can change this template. And once you complete your template, then you will just save and return. And now, once you predefine your template, you will be able to use it when you are creating action list, but you will be also able to use it if you already have an existing action list. So first, let me show you when you create a new action list. And now you see that we have a new action list template field when you will be choosing between templates from the submenu. And with this eye icon right next to it, you will be able to preview all these actions that will be imported into your action list. You can even preview your task details. And once you are ready with your action list and you save it, and now you can see that actions from template are imported into your action list. And if you have selected dates, they are displayed here too. And now let's say that you have already existing action list and you would like to add actions from your template. In that case, you have to click on these three little dots, and in the submenu, you will see a new field for import from template. So when you select it, now you will be able to choose your template. You will be able to choose position if you would like to have it positioned at the end or at the beginning. You will be once again able to preview these actions, and you will be also able to choose your main task. So if you are not already in your main task, you are able to select it right here and click import. And now you will see that these actions are added to your main task. And you have one more option how to use your action list template. Let's say that you will go to your subtasks. You can add it from here when you click on this icon, and you will complete the same details. Except because we were already located in our main task, it is pretty fine right here. So just a little summary. Action list template you can use when you are creating new action list, or you can add it under these three dots, or directly in your task and subtasks. And now let's go look at our checklist templates. As I mentioned earlier, our checklist template is enhanced and it will give you more options to work with. So when you go to your template, now you will see that your old templates will look this way. So it will be transformed into this new look. And there are two significant changes. First is that you are able to add as many levels and sub-levels as you need to, which before you were not able to do, and you just clicking this green plus button to add actions. And also the second one, when you click on your action, you will see that you can add more details. You can get details, labels, flags. You can also define your offset days, responsible approver attachments, and related documents the same way as in action list template. And lastly, our corrective actions template. And you will be able to use corrective actions template in modules using corrective actions, such as root cause analysis, AD reports, quality alerts, and so on. In their submenus, you will find corrective actions template. And when you go to your corrective actions template, it will be like before. When you predefine your corrective actions that need to happen with this template. And now let's say that we will go to one of our RCCA documents. And when you scroll down, under corrective preventive actions, you will be able to import your template by clicking either these three dots or once again directly in your main task or subtask. Safety alerts is one exception. When you are creating new safety alert, you will see you will be able to actually add your corrective action templates directly here. And once again, you will just choose from the submenu. You can preview the actions. And this is pretty much it. If you have any questions or need any assistance, please don't hesitate to contact us at support@teamguru.com. We would be very happy to hear from you.